What's it like to be beautiful? We can probably all imagine what life would be like if we were all perfect tens. But what we are thinking is nothing compared to the reality. This is especially true for beautiful people who aren't even legal adults. Want to know how much the most beautiful kids in the world make? Well, stay tuned to find out. New around here? Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. Now, let's take a look inside the lives of the most beautiful kids in the world. Beauty is only skin deep, at least that is how the saying goes. But is life actually different for those of us who are deemed beautiful? A lot of models and actresses will tell you that they blossomed after puberty. That means when they were children, they were shy and a bit awkward looking. But then there are those few people who just start out beautiful, the beautiful kids of the world. They seem just to have come out of the womb with dazzling eyes and unbelievably long lashes. Kids like Linnea Grace and Anastasia Bezrukova make even adult women envious. But what is it that makes these kids so beautiful? Many studies have found that faces that are more symmetrical are looked upon as more beautiful, but that is mostly in Western cultures. Studies have also found that specific lengths and widths of attributes also subconsciously translate as beautiful. Thankfully, most people believe that beauty is in the eye of the beholder, which could also be true. But when it comes down to it, if you've been in magazines like Harper's Bazaar and Vogue before the age of 13, we can all pretty much agree that you are universally accepted as good-looking. But such extreme beauty comes at a cost. While most children spend their days in school and their afternoons running around, that's not the case for these beautiful kids. Sadly, they tend to have modeling contracts that are very demanding of them from very young ages. Whereas most kids' biggest concern is which snack they will have when they come home from school, these children already have full-time jobs. Take Kristina Pimenova, for instance. Kristina signed a modeling contract when she was just 10 years old. She was discovered after constantly going to modeling gigs with her mom. Since then, she has worked with Vogue, Armani, Dolce & Gabbana, and is now signed to the youth section of LA Models. Do you think that busy schedule leaves her any time to play and just be a kid? Probably not. That is enough work to keep an adult busy. Most children are able to make their friends at school. But for child models and actors, their busy work schedule can get in the way of going to school on a normal schedule. That's why plenty of them choose a different route. They can choose to go to school over the internet through sites like K12.com. Unfortunately, that is quite an isolating choice. That's because the child just sits in front of the computer alone all day. On the other hand, they can be homeschooled. But again, that doesn't allow for much interaction with other children. That is, unless the kid has siblings or is homeschooled in some kind of group. They can also enroll in a professional children's school. These schools allow children to get out early and make up schoolwork that they have to miss, due to jobs. This is probably the best option for a model to have the closest thing to a normal childhood. They will be around other children and able to socialize. But those moments of normalness are still interrupted by stressful jobs and jet-setting from one country to another, which most kids just aren't doing. Another thing that separates these beautiful child models from other kids is the sheer amount of money they make. Most children aren't making anything at all. But depending on the level of modeling that they are doing, beautiful kids can make hundreds of thousands of dollars. Across the board, the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics said that in 2010, the average pay for a model was $42,560 per year, which is about $20.46 per hour. But the most beautiful kids in the world are landing jobs with huge publications like Vogue and major brands. So you can bet that their paychecks are exceeding that by hundreds of thousands. What is it like for a child to have all that money? The money does go to the parents, of course, but still, for a kid to be able to have anything that they want, whenever they want, probably doesn't exactly teach them patience, does it? In the past, children who make a lot of money have also found that it drove a wedge between them and their parents. That's because of the fact that the money belongs to their parents until the child is 18. Just look at some of the most beautiful child actors in the world who grew up to be very good-looking adult actors. A lot of them don't have very good relationships with their parents anymore. Take Drew Barrymore, for instance. She was a gorgeous kid who got into acting and modeling at a young age. In many interviews now, she has admitted that she doesn't have the best relationship with her mother and they just can't be in each other's lives. So while extreme wealth might sound like one of the highlights of being a beautiful child, it also comes with its drawbacks. Anytime a child is in the spotlight for their good looks, it makes some people a little wary. As long as the child is only a part of campaigns for children, everything is fine. But once since fashion magazines start hiring the kid, the shoots always run the risk of getting a little too risque. Let's look at child model Kristina Pimenova again. She has been called the most beautiful girl in the world by several publications, which is fine. But some of her pictures make it seem like she's being forced to grow up too fast. One photo that raises such questions is a picture where she is sitting on a stool in an oversized skirt that makes it seem like she's not wearing any pants. Actress Brooke Shields, who was also once considered one of the most beautiful children in the world, said that she is concerned about child models these days. This is mostly because of the dangers of the social media environment of today. Predators are real, and these children really have to make sure that they are not putting out images that attract them. For Kristina, her mother runs her Facebook page. She does so to protect her daughter from both creepy people and seeing all the sometimes not-so-nice comments that strangers may leave. It states on her page that all content shared on the page should be kid-friendly, meaning any video or pictures posted there that are not appropriate for someone Kristina's age will be deleted, not to mention that the person who posted it will be blocked from the page. Keeping the children somewhat separated from their social media accounts and fame is also a way that some of the parents ensure that their child doesn't become snobby and too self-indulgent. Kristina's parents don't allow her to sign autographs to keep her head from inflating. In an interview, her mother said that if Kristina thinks she is so important, that would not be normal and may cause her to develop problems merging with society later. Kristina doesn't even know how much money she has. In an interview, she said that she doesn't know much about money because she is a child, and children should not be aware of that stuff. When children realize their stardom at such a young age, it can be hard for them to process it, thus leading to significant problems when they are older. Just take a look at the many child actors and actresses who let fame get to their heads. Sadly, they had to deal with problems from over-partying and drug abuse when they got older. So, having parents that shield you from certain things can only work out for the child's benefit. Speaking of the problems that child stars run into the older they get, let's get to the main issue. Beautiful children do not always stay so beautiful. Everyone knows that puberty can be a rough time for anyone. You don't always come out of it looking like you did before. For beautiful children who have made their money off of their looks, that can be very unfortunate. Take Linnea Grace, for example. Right from the start, she was a beautiful child, and she began modeling at the young age of 3. She has been featured in campaigns for Guess and Maleficent toys. She was also in the music video for Avicii's Wake Me Up. Though she was a big star before her teen years, as she got older, her agency, the Ford Agency, shut down their kids' division. Linnea didn't book many jobs after that and instead waited until she could get her braces off to re-merge into the modeling world. Luckily, after her braces were removed, she was still exceptionally good-looking. That meant she was able to book more jobs. But not all the world's most beautiful kids are that lucky. For some, their appeal is only that they are children. So when they go from child to adult, they are no longer valuable to the industry. So what is life like for all those most beautiful kids who go on to be adults who aren't quite as popular? Someone who has experienced this firsthand is Mara Wilson. She is known for her roles in Matilda and Miss Doubtfire. She was once one of the cutest and most sought-after children in the industry, but as she got older, all that faded away. When she first started acting, everyone was crazy about her. She even said in an interview that her favorite part of the job was all the gifts that she received. Her parents tried to keep her as grounded as possible by keeping her in school. They also made her share a room with her sister, but she still caught on to the fact that she was famous. But as she got older, the roles started drying up, and she wasn't getting as much attention. She wrote in an article for Cracked that the adults around her knew the infatuation with her would fade, but she didn't. The years of money and adoration quickly became normal for her, so when it was taken away, it was basically like a real-life version of the movie Logan's Run. There is actually a scientific term for this phenomenon called hedonic adaption. It describes how someone gets used to a positive or negative stimuli and then has to struggle to adapt when the stimulus is gone. For the most beautiful children in the world, being beautiful and recognized for their beauty is the stimuli. Once that is gone and there are no more fans waiting to snap their pictures, it can be hard for the child to adapt. Even though the fame might not last forever, that doesn't mean the beautiful kids of the world aren't enjoying it right now. Just look at any of their Instagram. Linnea Grace has over 316,000 followers. Model Anastasia Bezrukova has over 200,000 followers, and Mackenzie Foy has over 600,000 followers. With those many followers, could you blame them if it went to their heads a little bit? We certainly wouldn't know what to do with all that fame. Just imagine thousands of people caring about what you are doing at any given second. It's insane. And even while they are still still at the height of their beauty, the spotlight is still not all that it's cracked up to be. Often the kids are on strict diets to maintain their figures, and they are always being watched. Whereas most children can make mistakes, throw fits, and act out with little or no consequences. With the world watching you, there is very little room for errors. These kids must make sure that every campaign they are a part of isn't too risque. They must make sure that all their actions don't hurt their brand or their chances of getting another job. Every child needs to be able to rebel at some point. It's how you figure out who you are and your own personal boundaries. Not having those opportunities can lead to breakdowns as an adult, as we have seen in stars such as Lindsay Lohan and Britney Spears. So while the lives of beautiful children may seem glamorous and like everything you ever wanted, there are quite a few downsides to be aware of. If they indulge too much in the rich and famous lifestyle, then they may end up steering themselves into a dangerous direction in adulthood. But if they don't enjoy it enough, then what is all the hard work for? When it comes to living as one of the most beautiful kids in the world, life is really a balancing act. That's it for Inside the Lives of the Most Beautiful Kids in the World. Were you surprised to see what goes on in their lives? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching!